What can your tongue tell you about your health? Now, as a mom, you might get mad if your kids stick their tongue out. But in Tibet, did you know it's actually a common greeting? Yep, keep that in mind next time you're about to scold your child. Now think back, what's one of the first habits your parents taught you as a little kid? To brush and floss your teeth, right? Well, if you're a parent, you can probably relate to this struggle. You see, good oral hygiene is essential for keeping your pearly whites healthy throughout your life. But there's more to oral health than just your teeth. In your mouth lies an organ that can give key insights into your overall health, and it's in plain sight. That's the nice thing. What organ is it? Well, it's your tongue, of course. Maybe you brush or scrape your tongue, but you might not pay too much attention to it beyond that. But this muscular organ does a lot more for us. Besides helping you speak, swallow, and taste, it's also a key part of the immune system. Yes, I did say immune system, the part of your body that is defense against everything from viruses to cancers. What's one of the first things your doctor does when he or she sees you now? Or I should say used to, that's back in the day when they still examine patients. Well, the doc says, say, ah, put your tongue out, and they put a tongue depressor on it. Remember, back in my day, we didn't have scans like CTs and MRIs available. We actually relied on the physical exam. It was key. That's what was fun about medicine to me, that we were always trying to figure out what's going on with the patient through looking at them, through listening, and one of the main things we did was look at the tongue and oral cavity. There's so much there. In fact, the tongue is made up of three different parts. The first part is the oral tongue, which is the part you see in your mouth. The second part is the body, which extends from the back of the mouth down the throat. And the third part is the lingual tonsils, which sit at the top of the tongue. You see, the anterior part of the tongue has an incredibly important job. It helps the body set up an immune response when it comes into contact with pathogens like viruses or bacteria that can potentially make you sick. Sure, your tongue helps you communicate to others, but it's also communicating to you if you pay attention to it. Number one is what's called smooth tongue. Usually bumps and lumps are a sign of a rash or other issues on your body, right? But not on your tongue. In fact, a bumpy tongue is a healthy one, but having a smooth tongue is a sign of nutritional deficiencies like iron. Iron is one of the most common. You're probably wondering what a smooth tongue has to do with your iron levels. Why would that be? Well, there's a direct link between them. The tissues in your mouth, especially those on your tongue, are always renewing themselves. That's why, say you bite the inside of your cheek or your tongue, the wound tends to heal faster than, say, a cut would somewhere else, like on your hand or your skin elsewhere. But when you don't have enough iron, your red blood cells have a hard time effectively delivering blood to tissues throughout your body, including those in your tongue, what's called your filiform papillae. Those are the small cone-shaped structures that give your tongue its texture. They get worn down naturally, but without enough blood flow to those tissues, your tongue has a hard time growing new filiform papillae, and thus it becomes smooth or bald. We call it atrophic laceitis. These people may also experience chronic dry mouth. In fact, a scientific review found 20% of people with a bald-like tongue have anemia, and about 5% of them were deficient in vitamin B12. Luckily, this can usually be diagnosed and treated with a simple blood test and a combination of supplements and changes to your diet. Before we go on to number two, here's a little fun fact. Did you know our tongue is made up of 8 different muscles that allow you to tackle those tongue-twisting words? Yeah. 8 of them. It's not just one. Number two, white spots, red spots, or lesions. Look at this graph of oral cancers, and they're on the rise, both for men and women. And it's substantial. Now, I don't want to cause any alarm or scare, but keep in mind that the best way to stay on top of your health is through education, awareness, and prevention. That's especially true when it comes to catching cancers early. Seeing white or red spots or lesions on your tongue can potentially be a symptom of certain types of oral cancers. Tongue cancers most commonly occur on the underside of the tongue or along the sides of it. Now, these tongue cancers usually appear as red and or white patches, but they could also look like a growth, even a sore. What's distinct about tongue cancers versus another sort of wound that might be on your tongue is that the cancer spot is usually solitary, so it's a single one, and it typically grows over the course of a few months, and sometimes even might take a year or two, but it usually steadily grows. That's something, it doesn't go away fully and then come back like a sore might. Now, please understand that most spots and sores that you see on your tongue are benign. They're not as significant in a sense. But it's important to have oral cancers on your radar because if they spread to the lymph nodes and they or systemically through your body, they become much more difficult to treat. Once you get to know your mouth, you'll know if you see anything new. So that's why it's important to look all the time and you get to know what it looks like in a healthy state and you can follow it over time. Now, before we go on to number three, do you know the five tastes that the tongue has? Can you name them? Pause this for a second if you want to try and name them, but they are salty, sour, bitter, sweet, and savory. Number three, the next abnormality you may see on your tongue are white patches. While it can be concerning to see white patches, and it's often something that drives people into their doctor because they just look and they haven't looked before to compare. They go, oh, there's a white spot. That's bad. It's not usually a problem, but white patches on your tongue are most commonly caused by a benign condition called geographic tongue or migratory glossitis. It's a harmless inflammatory condition that can cause patches of those filiform papillae, the same bumps we just talked about. Well, they disappear from patches along your tongue. When your filiform papillae disappear, it leaves behind that sort of patchwork effect of the white and the red. These spots or lesions, as some people call them, can cause a little bit of soreness, but usually, the key is here, they don't cause any discomfort. Now, this is a fairly common condition that you'll notice, and it can go away and come back, go away and come back. So you'll notice it waxes and wanes. While geographic tongue, it's typically harmless on its own, it has been linked to several health conditions like eczema, psoriasis, diabetes, or reactive arthritis. So keep that in mind, and if you have one of those, that makes sense that you might have more what we call geographic tongue. In terms of nutritional deficiencies, think zinc, iron, folic acid, and vitamin B6 and 12. Keep yourself attuned to those. Now, before we go to number four, let's do another fun fact. You have anywhere from 3,000 to 10,000 taste buds. So can you see taste buds on your tongue? Well, while you can't see individual ones without magnification, of course, you can sometimes see larger taste papillae, which are the bumps on the tongue that contain clusters of taste buds. Now, number four, a thick white coating on your tongue. If you see that, it could be indicative of infection like oral candida or a yeast infection called oral thrush. Well, what causes this? Well, it's much more common in people with immune compromising states like HIV or certain medications or antibiotics. You'll often see it in kids as they're building up their immune response. They might get thrush because they don't quite have the immunity of adults. Luckily, this only lasts for a couple weeks and usually goes away, but keep attuned to any immune compromised situations. Number five, what if you have a painful sore like this one? Well, these can be caused by herpes simplex virus, manifesting as oral herpes. These typically look like white or mixed red and white ulcers, but these are often painful, a distinction from a prior problem that we talked about. These are painful. Herpes outbreaks can typically be managed with certain medications and lifestyle changes. You can see it's important to pay attention to any changes you see in your tongue and consult with your healthcare provider if something seems off, but get to know what it looks like in its healthy state and examine it at least monthly. Now, I made this video here on five lab tests your doctor is not ordering for you. And one down here, there's a playlist on red, infrared, and LED light therapy to help you reduce the inflammation in your body to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.